Have you ever gone to analyze your data? You open up your comp matrix and it looks like this? Dun dun dun. Comp problems everywhere. I've had a number of requests on the channel for how do I fix my compensation matrix. Today we're going to go through how to troubleshoot the issues with your compensation matrix, how to assess what those issues are, how you can fix them, if possible, how to change your controls in the future so you can avoid them, and then at the very end, I will show you how you can edit a compensation matrix. Editing a matrix is a last resort. It is not something that you should be doing willy-nilly all the time. No cowboys in here. This is something that is reserved at worst case scenario. There's nothing else you can do and you gotta save this data. We'll go through some of the rules on how to do this when we get there, but keep in mind this should be your last resort, not the first thing you go to when your comp matrix looks bad. So you think your compensation matrix is bad. The first thing I would recommend doing is going back to your controls. First off, you want to check to make sure that they followed all of the rules. Generally, when you see poor compensation results, something is off with your controls. First up, double check that all your controls are brighter than your sample. Again, compensation can only compensate up to the point where your control was. So if your samples are brighter, there will be errors. Second of all, were your compensation controls made fresh? Or are you using controls from a previous experiment? Or old samples from the fridge? All of these will affect your compensation that day. And the one that I see most commonly was, were your compensation controls treated the same way as your samples? Say your samples have gone through a number of wash steps, a fixation, a permeabilization, more washes. All of these can affect the fluorochromes on your cells, and that will affect how they compensate. Because if your spectra are different, they're not going to compensate identically. So if in your experiment you have cells that were fixed and permeabilized, and your compensation controls are beads that you just added antibody to and washed away, those aren't necessarily going to be the same, and that can lead to comp errors. So you want to make sure that your comp controls are being treated the same way as your samples were in that experiment. Those are the three most common things that I see happening when compensation looks bad. Again, there's other things that can go into it, but those are the first three things I would recommend you assess. Second up, start going into the actual data, which we'll get to in a second. It could just be that the data wasn't gated quite right when it was compensated, and adjusting your gates can remove a lot of those issues. You may also run into a point where maybe you didn't have enough events, and if in your next experiment you acquire enough events, your compensation problems may go away. If you remember from the earlier comp videos, compensation relies on an accurate calculation of the median. So if you don't have enough events in the negative or the positive, your median won't be accurate and your compensation will be off. Another thing that a lot of people panic about, which I'll show you here, is the compensation might look really bad when you haven't applied any gates to your data. But as soon as you remove the debris and the doublets and the dead cells, suddenly you have a beautiful looking matrix. So remember that those things like debris and doublets and dead cells can cause a lot of artifacts in your data, and it's not necessarily a compensation error you're seeing, but artifacts from results you're never going to analyze anyways. And finally, if you go through all of this and nothing's quite working, a lot of the times if you've compensated with beads, switching those comp controls back to cells can fix a lot of your problems. You're dealing with something that's more directly comparable, and so you may be able to abrogate some of those problems even if you have a mix of, say, cells and beads in your comp matrix where you put some of your more problematic ones back onto cells. So there's a few troubleshooting things that you can go through right when you see your data, a few things you can try in future experiments, but now let's get in and actually look at this comp matrix and what I would do when I saw something that looks like this one does. So first up, when we look in the data, you'll see there's a lot of events leaning in towards the center. Now right now I'm looking at every single event that was captured by the cytometer, and I'm using the acquisition defined matrix. So right now if we change this preview population to my already defined cells gate, you'll see by removing the debris, a lot of those bad looking events disappear. And this gets even better with single cells, and even better when I look at just the alive cells. You will notice though, we still have some issues. Like over here, leaning down here, we have a lot of events stuck on the axis right here. So the second thing I would then look for is events that potentially look really bright, really off. And if you notice, in my Y586 channel, you can see I have a lot of events here stuck right on the axis. And a lot of the issues I'm seeing in my compensation are actually having to do with that Y586 channel. So let's go back into the data and take a look at what it looks like. So if we go into our alive cells and we look at our Y586 stain, which would be EPE, again, in the sample, you can see a lot of those events are stuck on the axis. If we go into our compensation control, looking at that same axis, you'll see they kind of sit around 10 to the 5, which means that our issue here is caused by our antibody on our cells being brighter, or our stain on our cells being brighter than it was on our compensation control. And because of that, we're not compensating properly. So as you can see here, all of the stain on our cells is actually brighter than what we had on our comp controls. And that's why we have so many issues in this experiment. It's because this area can't be properly accounted for, can't be properly compensated. So how do we fix this? Well, we can't, because the data is acquired and we can't change the intensity after our data is acquired. What I would recommend for this experiment in the future is first off to go and titrate this antibody, bring that signal down. You can probably also decrease the voltage here somewhat, but make sure that these two are more in line with each other so that your comp control is brighter than this and you aren't recording off-scale events. Off-scale events are never a good thing. Ignoring that we can't fix that though, let's take a look at the compensation and see if there's some things that we can do to make it look a little bit better. So I'll work through the process I would usually use. So going into the comp area, like I mentioned, we were using the acquisition defined compensation matrix. I like to go back into FlowJo when my compensation looks weird off of the machine and see how things are gated and if those gates being changed can change any of the data. So let's go through one by one, and right now we're going to gate all of them so that we're capturing the entire positive population like you normally would when you're gating. Now that all those are gated, let's go ahead and view this matrix. So you'll see here, we now have two matrices, one that was the acquisition defined, one that we've just created. Now, there are slight differences between the two. It'd be hard to tell these right off the bat because all the columns and rows adjusted. But you'll notice that this is maybe slightly improved, but we do see a lot of the errors caused by that Y586 being too bright. Again, that can't be corrected. But this looks, overall, ignoring the Y586, pretty good. And we do see some leaning, but again, that's going to be related to our overly bright. Now, if you've done this in FlowJo and it still doesn't look quite right, another trick you can use is actually to go in and adjust your gates so that you're only gating on the brightest part of that population. So again, compensation being a calculation of the mean or the median, if you only grab the highest part of your histograms, you're going to increase that median, make it higher, and sometimes that will give you a slightly better compensation result. So let's go through and take a look at what that does. And again, when you're doing this, make sure you're grabbing enough events in the gate that you can still calculate it. You don't want to bring it so far over to the edge that there's nothing in there. Thankfully, if you go too low, FlowJo will usually flag that for you and tell you that you don't have enough events in your gate. But just be mindful of that when you're doing it. let's take a look at this one. So this is our new matrix when we gate only on the highest percentage of cells. And you can see this also still looks quite good. The only errors we have at this point are related to the overcompensation of that signal that's too bright. Now, I know a lot of people get worried when they see FlowJo highlighting something in this dark orange or dark red color, like there's inherently something wrong because that percentage is so high. When you see that, don't panic. Don't automatically assume that it's wrong. When you look through that channel, you'll see that we actually don't really have any comp errors because of that. And if we're going to go back into our experiment, say, and open up, let's close that guy. So it was the live dead versus the PE size 7. You'll see that this looks really nicely compensated, but let's get out of here, which is just the alive cells, so that you can see what this looks like in cells that have dead cells. So let's go up a gate. So you can see here, it's really nicely compensated. There's no really obvious issues. So those big numbers don't always need to be a scary thing. If your controls are right, then the value's right. That's as simple as it is. Okay, the part that I know you've all been requesting, the part that people want to see, is how do I go and edit a matrix? So as you're doing this, again, this is not something that you should approach cavalierly. It's not something that you should just do because you can. You should always do this with a reason, and you should do it because you have no other option. When doing this, the basic rule to follow is you want the median of your negative population to match the median of your positive population. So in this plot here, the Y780 versus the BV530, let's just zoom in on that so you can see this more clearly. You can see that we have a lot of overcompensation here. Again, that is a byproduct of the controls not being correct. We can ourselves correct for this. So to do that, we're going to go into the edit button and it's going to give you a warning and you can click yes. So that will open up the editing option. You can see these boxes you can now click and type in. So our channel of interest is this Y586 and B530, and you can see right now it has a compensation value of just over 2%. So what happens if we change this to 0? You can see it will go through and calculate, and now this population is pulled off. You can see we're probably a little bit undercomped, our medians aren't quite lined up, and this is where you can spend hours just playing around with data. So something about like that. Again, it's not going to be perfect because, again, the stain was too bright, but it does give us that option. And you'll see when we do that, so if we go back to where it was at 2.2, we have all these events sitting down on the bottom of this axis here. But when we go ahead and manually correct that, you'll see that those all pull off. So that is an artifact, again, of that sample being too bright and not properly compensated, can be corrected when we go in here. So if you were editing your matrix, essentially what you would do is scroll through your n by n plots and look for areas like right here where you have weird leans in your populations. So this is the V610 and it's going to be the Y586. And so if we go along this Y586 to the V610 and scroll back down so you can see it, let's see what happens when we turn that to 0. You can see this is now undercompensated. So we'll just, now we're back overcompensated. Now we're nicely compensated. So this is where, I guess you could spend literally hours doing this. I don't recommend it. This is like last case scenario. Don't do this every time. Go back, correct your controls, fix that for your future experiments. This is merely to help you save your data for that day. Okay? I think I've gotten that point across. But you can see now with a few tweaks in our gates, by looking at our population of interest and removing the debris, And by doing a few slight adjustments to our matrix, we now have a really nice looking compensation matrix that we can apply to our samples and that we can use to do our analysis. If this was my experiment, I would definitely go back and in my future experiments bring down this Y586 dye. Simply by doing that and having my controls and my sample in line with each other, I would avoid having to do most of the things I've just shown you how to do. So, driving the point home, there is no magic with compensation. It is a mathematical calculation. If your controls are correct, if you've gated them properly, your compensation is correct. When you see errors in your compensation matrix, it always goes back to the controls. So remember the main things to check. Have you followed all the basic rules? Are your dyes matched? Are they brighter than your samples? Have you collected enough events? Is your autofluorescence matched? Then check out and look at the protocol by which you made your compensation controls. Were they made fresh? Were they made the same day? Were they run the same day? Did you follow the same staining protocol that you did on your cells? All of these things will affect how your compensation runs, and you want to keep that as exactly matched to your experiment as possible to get the best compensation you can. And with that, happy matrixing, and we'll see you in the next one.